How can Python and R users use the R matching package for causal inference with Logit Propensity Score Matching? Causal inference has well-established packages in R, but not in Python. This tutorial provides an example of using R packages for causal analysis in a Python notebook. If you are a Python user, please follow the steps in the tutorial to set up the environment to run the R package matching for propensity score matching. To learn more about how to run R in a Python notebook, please check out my previous tutorial How to Use R with Google Colab Notebook. If you are an R user, please ignore the Python code and use the R code directly. R code are the ones starting with %R or %%R. Welcome to Grab and Go Info. In this tutorial, you will learn how do the propensity score matching algorithms work, how to conduct propensity score matching or Logit propensity score matching using the R package matching, how to check the balance of the matched dataset, how to calculate causal impact using a paired t-test. Let's get started. Propensity score matching takes a sample in the treatment group and finds a sample with a similar propensity score or Logit propensity score in the non-treatment group. The goal of matching is to create the treatment and the control groups that are comparable. The propensity score matching process involves the following steps. 1. Create a matching dataset based on similarities and the probability of getting the treatment. The probability of getting the treatment is called the propensity score. 2. Evaluate the balance of the matched dataset. If the matched dataset is balanced, meaning that the test and control dataset has similar confounders, move forward to the next step. If the matched dataset is not balanced, go back to the first step, adjust the hyperparameters, and redo the propensity score matching. 3. Measure the causal impact. In this tutorial, we will use a paired t-test to measure the impact of the treatment. In step 1, we will install and import libraries. Firstly, let's install DAWI for dataset creation. Then, we activate the rmagic command in the Google Colab notebook using rpy2 and install the R packages table 1, matching, gtools, lmtest, and sandwich. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. The datasets is imported from DAWI for dataset creation. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Packages from rpy2 are imported for Python to R conversion. Then we imported the R libraries, table 1, matching, gtools, lmtest, and sandwich. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me as a content creator and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the causal inference. Firstly, we set a random seed using np.random.seed to make the dataset reproducible. Then a dataset with the true causal impact of 10, 4 confounders, 10,000 samples, a binary treatment variable, and a continuous outcome variable is created. After that, we created a data frame for the data. In the data frame, the columns W0, W1, W2, and W3 are the 4 confounders. V0 is the treatment indicator, and Y is the outcome. Next, let's rename V0 to treatment, rename Y to outcome, and convert the Boolean values to 0 and 1. Finally, the Python data frame is converted to R data frame to use R packages on the dataset. In step 3, we will get the unadjusted difference between the treatment group and the non-treatment group. If we do not use causal inference and take the direct difference between the two groups, we conclude that the treatment increased the outcome by 16, which is much higher than the true causal impact of 10. In step 4, we will check the standardized mean difference between the treatment group and the non-treatment group. Var equals confounders means that we will summarize the data for the 4 confounders. Strata equals treatment means that the variables will be grouped by the treatment type. Test equals true means the p-value for the significance testing will be reported. SMD equals true means that the standardized mean difference will be reported. Standardized mean differences greater than 0.1 is usually used to check the imbalance between the treatment and the control group. We can see that most confounders have SMD greater than 0.1 with a significant p-value, meaning that the confounders differ between the treatment group and the non-treatment group. In step 5, we will build a model to predict propensity scores. The function glm fits a generalized linear model. The propensity score is the probability of getting the treatment, so we need to use the confounders to predict the probability of getting the treatment. Family equals binomial means that we are running a logistic regression. Propensity model $ fitted. Values gets the predicted propensity scores and saves it into a variable called propensity score. Summary gives us the summary of the model. In step 6, we will discuss using the R matching package to do the propensity score matching. After getting the propensity score, we can pass it to the match function for propensity score matching. TR equals DFR treatment specifies the column name of the treatment indicator variable. M equals 1 means that we are conducting one-to-one matching. Every treatment unit will be matched with one control unit. X equals propensity score means that the match is based on the propensity score values. Replace equals F means that each sample in the control group is only matched with one sample in the treatment group. The control group unit will not be put back after matching. A caliper is the distance threshold for any match. The matched pairs with a distance greater than the caliper distance will be dropped. Caliper equals 0.2 means that matches greater than 20% of the standard deviations of propensity score will be dropped. After matching was completed, the match dataset was put into the createTable1 function for balance checking. We can see that 792 units were matched, and the standardized mean difference for all the confounders is below 0.1 with insignificant p-values. Another way of doing propensity score matching is to match on the Logit propensity score. The code for matching is very similar to the regular propensity score matching. The only difference is that x equals propensity score is replaced with x equals Logit propensity score. After matching on the Logit propensity score, we can see that 880 units were matched, and the standardized mean difference for all the confounders is below 0.1 with insignificant p-values. In step 8, we will estimate the treatment effect using the match data. A pair t-test is used on both the propensity score matching dataset and the Logit propensity score matching dataset. For the propensity score matching dataset, we can see that the estimated causal impact is 10.39. The 95% confidence interval is 10.01 to 10.77. The hypothesis testing is significant because the p-value is close to zero. For the Logit propensity score matching dataset, we can see that the estimated causal impact is 10.35. The 95% confidence interval is 10.00 to 10.70. The hypothesis testing is significant because the p-value is close to zero. From the pair t-test result, we can see that Logit propensity score matching has a more accurate causality estimation than the propensity score matching for this dataset. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about causal inference, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.